Welcome to chapter one. So chapter one is about, it's just an introduction about pharmacology, and we're going to learn how to write prescriptions as well. So here are the learning objectives. Let's look at this word pharmacology. So if you break it down, pharma comes from the word drugs, and the ology means study of. Okay, so pharmacology is basically the study of drugs. Study of drugs, and what it does is it looks at how the drugs interact with the body. Okay, so are we having a positive effect on the body? Are we having a negative effect on the body? Are we having both positive and negative effects? So we're going to learn about, what drugs do to our body. Also, at the point to note is the ology always means study of. So if you think of zoology, zoology is like a study of animals. If you think of psychology, psych deal. This part means studies, the study of, and psych kind of means human behavior, the study of human behavior. If you think of periodontology, so the study of the periodontium, right? And periodontium, if you remember, it means like the structures around the teeth. And you'll learn more about that in perio class. So this picture over here is plants. So you'll see plants here, and you'll see that drugs can be made from plants. So caffeine, for example, they're saying could be made from plants. Codeine could be made from a plant. And so way back when, or actually way back before, there were certain plants that change behavior in the body. There were certain plants that made you feel better. There were certain plants that made you feel less sick or made the cough go away. And then what happened was people realized that, oh, plants are actually effective. Plants can actually do some things, can trigger responses in your body. This is important because when we move on in the course, one of the chapters looks at herbal supplements, and we'll be learning how herbal supplements can also affect the body and why we as a hygienist or we as dental professionals need to know the relationship between herbs or herbal supplements and the mouth. So, what is our role? It is really important for us to take a thorough medication and health history. And the reason why is because there are lots of medications that our clients could be taking that could interact with their body, that could interact with their mouth, and it could, some people could have dry mouth, some people could have ulcers in their mouth, some people could be breaking out in their mouth. So sometimes knowing what medications they're taking can help. Appointment scheduling is also important, and the reason why is if someone has asthma or if someone is diabetic, we need to schedule early appointments because early appointments work best for them. And we'll talk more about that when we get to that chapter. But for now, just know that people who are diabetic or people that have asthma, we want to schedule early appointments. This is someone who has dry mouth. So as I said, anyone who's taking medications, there are like over 400 medications that could cause dry mouth, that could cause xerostomia. So it's important to know the link between medications and xerostomia. And here we can see some herbal medicine. We also want our clients to say any nutritional or herbal supplements because there is a relationship. There are some herbs that can cause ulcers. There are some herbal medicine that can cause xerostomia. So we want to know what herbs or what herbal medication they're taking. So one of the ways we can find out more about the drugs they're taking is Lexicon. So Lexicon is basically an app or a software which I will walk you guys through. And all you do, it looks like this when you log into the Georgian public li a Georgian college library, and you put in the drug, you hit enter, and then it tells you all the information you need to know about that drug. So Lexicon is a really valuable resource that we have. So let's look at drug names. So when we have drug names, there are three different types of drug names. There's a chemical name, there's a trade or brand name, and there's a generic name. And chemical name is basically a chemical structure of the compound. So I'll give you an example. Let's go to the next slide. These over here are chemical names. Can you see how they're really, really long compared to their generic and brand name? That's how you know it's a chemical name. Usually they have some fancy terminology, fancy words over here. Okay, so a chemical name is the chemical compound. Then we have the generic name, and the generic name is the official name. Okay, so it's the official name. It's the name that's given to the medicine before it gets marketed. Okay, so before it goes out to the market, there's a generic name or an official name that's given to the drug. Notice how that the generic name always starts with a lowercase. Okay, so generic names start with lowercase. Brand names, on the other hand, have an uppercase because this is now it's been marketed. Okay, so whenever it's been marketed, it's given a brand or a trade name. So going back to the previous slide, here's an example. A generic name is ibuprofen. Okay, and we may recognize ibuprofen as Advil. So notice how the ibuprofen has a lowercase I, but the Advil has a capital A. So if it's capital, it's likely a trade name. If it's lowercase, it's likely a generic name. And here we can see that a brand name is right here, and a generic or no-name brand is over here. What you'll notice is look at the price difference. This is $12.96, whereas this is $9.99. So sometimes when you're, walking in the pharmacy aisle and you're wondering, should I take Advil or should I take Exact ibuprofen? Exact is actually, I think, is from Superstore or Loblaws. That's where this name is coming from. So if you have that question, whether you should get Advil or the no-name brand, the answer to that in the textbook is that it really doesn't matter. At the end of the day, they both have the same ingredients inside the medicine. They both work just as well. It doesn't matter whether you could, buy the brand name or you could buy the generic, it'll be the same effect. It'll still work. The reason why they say that the brand is pricier than this one is because when the medication first got tested and it got approved to get marketed, usually Advil, paid a lot of money to get it marketed, to get it to tested as well. Whereas ibuprofen, it didn't pay as much money, so the brand is trying to make up the cost. Because they put in a lot of money to get it marketed. They put in a lot of money to get it tested to make sure that it's safe. So at the end, whether you get the brand name or the generic name, what the textbook is saying is the same thing. It'll give you the same effect. One medication is not better than the other medication. And also what this is saying here is that for it to get approved, so for it to actually go on these pharmacy shelves, it has to be FDA approved. And FDA, we'll talk about, is Food and Drug Administration. And it's basically an administration that looks after all the drugs, all the food, and it will only allow the safe ones to go on the market or to go on the shelf. So the fact that Exact ibuprofen is on the market, is on the pharmacy shelves, shows that it's safe and shows that it's effective as well. Okay, so let's say we have two drugs here. We have, let's say the blue one is Advil and this orange one is no name Advil. Okay, so no name ibuprofen. Let's compare these two drugs. Are those two drugs chemically equivalent? Yes, those two drugs have the same chemical structure. The blue one has the same chemical structure as the orange one. Okay, so they're chemically equivalent. That means they have the same chemical structure inside their capsule, inside the pill. Are they biologically equivalent? This means that do they have the same amount of drug inside the bloodstream? And the answer should be yes. The blue drug, or the blue pill and the orange pill, should have the same amount of Advil, for example, of ibuprofen rather, inside the bloodstream. So same concentration or same amount. Are they also therapeutically equivalent? That means that does the blue and the orange pill work the same? Will they make you feel better? And yes, the answer is they should also make you feel better. For it to be FDA approved, Okay, so for the medication to be FDA approved, it needs to be biologically equivalent and therapeutically equivalent, which means that it needs to go into the bloodstream. The concentration of the medicine should be in the bloodstream. It should be equal in the bloodstream, rather. Okay, so the medication should be equal in the bloodstream, and they should both make you feel better. So, Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, that is important because it determines which drug can be sold by the prescription and over the counter.